guys, welcome back to part two. This is something which I use a lot, primarily because I tend to play a lot of folk music and a lot of Indian music as well, like Bollywood songs and other Indian classical songs. And also there was a time when I started playing piano where I had absolutely no clue of triads beyond like the white note triads like C major, F major and G major. And I'm sure a lot of y'all have gone through the same problem. So I developed this trick. I think I really don't know how it happened, but it seems to have worked out for me at least during my beginner level days. And till then, I've never considered or now when I look back, I don't consider it as a beginner technique because I still use the technique. So if you're just starting off on the keyboard, you can use this to help you play chords a little bit more easily, maybe a lot more easily. And also if you're playing folk music and if you like a lot of rhythmic stuff in your piano playing, this technique is also quite nice. So let's see how it works. So the first thing you need to know is the fifth chord or the power chord is built in a really, really ridiculously simple manner. It's just one, the root, then it's fifth and the octave. You can even avoid the octave, you'll still get the similar sound. And a lot of guitar players tend to like to play it in the lower regions. You'll have like... That's, I guess, where the power name comes into play, right? However, in this lesson, I'm not going to focus on playing the chord in this hand. It's going to be played in this hand. So if you have a progression, D, B minor, E minor, and A major, what you could do, if you don't know those chords, or if you're finding it tough to shift, because it's a lot of work and planning if you're new, is you could... just keep the D fifth, name of the scale, D major again, and the D fifth can either be built as 1 5 one octave D A D or 5 1 5 octave, which is essentially the same notes jumbled up in another way or in an inversion, as some people officially say. So D A D A D A, you can perhaps play it higher if you wish. Decide where you like it the most based on your singer and the song you're playing. And the left hand is not just going to stay D. It's going to follow the bass notes of the chord progression you guys are playing. So in this case, in this entire series, I'm choosing the 1 6 2 5, which is D, B, E, and A. So I'm not going to play chords in the left hand because I feel... creates a very muddy sound in any case. So playing single notes perhaps with octaves will be nice. So you go. You're essentially doing chord roots and you're just holding the fifth chord here, either this way or the DAD way. ADA way, which is the inversion. Another thing you can do to add on to this technique is perhaps instead of playing just the octave, you can play a third of each note, right? If you're a bit doubtful about thirds, I would suggest you to watch the previous part where I've talked about third formation. That'll help you guys. But in any case, it's quite easy. 1 2 3. So with every chord root, you add the third. B with D, E with G. So maybe you'd want to play it a bit higher because the thirds start cluttering up the sound, right? Octaves and get a more deeper sound. I like to do with the right hand from time to time is, of course, play around with this with the shape, but don't change the basic notes, which are A, D, A, or D, A, D. So if I take A, D, A, you can just add anywhere your thumb is sort of, wanting to play this B. So you could also play it. Or maybe you can add this E. Or you can add an F sharp. So you can add notes off the scale. You don't want to add that, because that's not part of the D scale. You can add things like B, C sharp, E, F sharp, G, anything in the vicinity of the chord. That makes it very interesting and a lot more colorful. So you can also build like a mini melody, like so basically it's all around the fifth chord, but then you add a couple more notes to it. So you can find different options here. I'm doing a lot of this D plus E thing with my thumb, because you can. It's right there. So these are some cheat codes which pianists do from time to time. And if you're playing a lot of groovy, like folk music, I think this technique will really help, because it keeps the sound very simple. The listener doesn't have to hear the chord over and over and over again. They are just digesting a very small, simple sound, which is the fifth, against some interesting bass notes. So if you want to groove, instead of playing like that, I'm trying to groove it. D, B minor, E minor, A. Right? So you can again apply this to a lot of pop songs. For example, again, if you take the Beatles' Let It Be, which we've been seeing in this series. When I find myself in times of trouble, Mother Mary comes to me, speaking words of wisdom, let it be, yeah. In my hour of darkness, she is standing right in front of me, speaking. Can see the right hand was absolutely the same throughout, right? So if you're just starting off on the piano, I think that could be a nice way to play pop songs. Just find the bass notes, or you can Google the chords. If it says D major, you don't have to play the whole triad. You can just play a fifth chord of that scale, which in the D case is DAD or ADA, and in the left hand you just play the chord roots. And it's not you might argue that it's sounding simpler because it's simpler to play, but the sound is not very simple. It's quite an exciting sound, right? That's like a B minor seventh. It's like an E minor seventh. That's a suspended sound. So you are actually building some very exciting chord voicings and some very exciting sounds. So it's not really a beginner level technique, but if you're unaware of triads just now, you could definitely use it if you're a beginner. And if you already play the piano, and if you've been playing for a few years, you can use this technique to also spice up your voicing. You can also add notes in between, and so on and so forth. Right, so that's about power chords and how you can use the fifth chords in your songs. And don't forget to check out our learning material at the link provided. You can go through all the slides which I've been talking about, all the chords. We've also notated it using staff notation and stuff like that. Okay, cheers.